ladies and gentlemen. I welcome you all to the headquarters of CI Force Victor, the headquarter which is looking after all operations in South Kashmir. And last evening, early morning, the early hours today, we received an information of presence of two terrorists in the area of Hakripora, which is near Niwa. By about 4 in the morning, the police as well as the army, we had established a cordon in the same, in the concerned houses. There were about 10-12 houses which were the reported area. Subsequently, we closed in, we spoke to the house owner, and we learned that the terrorists were not allowing the members of the house family to come out. After a couple of hours, after talking to them, all the members of the family came out, and that is the time after that we launched our operations. Started off around in the early hours of this morning, after 8 or so, and within a couple of hours, two terrorists have been killed. This includes Abu Dujana, the Lashkar-e-Toiba chief for Kashmir, a category A++ terrorist, and in addition, along with him was Arif Nabi Dar, and Arif Dar also is a wanted terrorist. He had been involved in a number of bank robberies, in a number of weapon snatching incidents, and so today both of them have been killed. Abu Dujana is a foreign terrorist, Pakistani, and after that we have wound up the operations and we have pulled back to our bases. Thank you.
As the co-commander 15 Corps has already given the brief of today's operation, I'll add that both the killed militants were notorious and important in a way that they had established their strongholds in certain areas due to coercion and threatening and so many other things. So it had become imperative to neutralize them in the interest of peace and in the interest of safety of general masses. So today, as the co-commander has already said, we received information in the 3 hours of the morning about their presence, and one thing which we did to them, we tried hard to make them surrender. Announcements were made from mosques, and we tried to utilize the services of the house owner and the persons who came out of the house to impress upon them to surrender. But because of Dujana's presence, the other presence were also not surrender. And ultimately, you know what it is like that, it's like that. They started firing, and the quantum of fire from their side was very heavy. It was retaliated, and both were neutralized. After the operation was over, properly the bodies were identified. And one was Abu Dujana and the other one was Arif. So it was a clean operation, but for the civilian casualty of Firdaus Khan of Begumbar and around 5 to 6 injured pellet injuries and 2 bullet injuries. Initially, as it happens, in spite of our warnings and in spite of our requests, the people, on the behest of it, I have been repeating it in every press conference, the people on the behest of these militants, maybe coercion or threatening, they tend to come in between the operating parties and the militants, and that's how they get injured or killed. Today also it happened in the same manner. And we lost the civilian's life. Regrettable, but it could have been avoided if the people stay inside and let the security forces do their job. These things won't happen. I take this opportunity and again appeal to the people, because the operations will be carried out. Pelting or no pelting, disruptions or no disruptions, the operations will go on. Whenever we get information of militants, armed militants, in a house in any area, the operations are to be launched. And yes, we are trying that they surrender, but if they don't surrender and they start firing on the forces, the only reply is to retaliate. That's what is being done. And Corps Commander has already mentioned about the activities, nefarious activities of Arif. Weapon snatching, looting, then killing of Sarpanch. Remember, there was a killing of Sarpanch. Abu, it was which area? Pulwama.
PDP
president
also? Yes, he was the
president.
Then? He was Fayaz Ahmad Dar. Ex-Sarpanch Fayaz Ahmad Dar and killed by Arif Dar.
And Dujana, you know, he had become more a nuisance in the area by way of, I don't want to use those words. He had become an eyesore for everybody, especially the girls in the area. It was his sweet dream now to enter any house and do whatever he wanted to do. Good riddance, that way. I think people should relax, the girls, our sisters, they should relax now. That no such persons will be there to harass them anymore. Thank you very much.
Tent on the capability of Lashkar. Abu Dujana, but in his operational capability in the last 1 year or so, what we have seen, he was not involved in too many operations. Like the IGP mentioned, he was more of a nuisance. He was more involved in coercion and not many in terms of terrorist acts. So he was more of only enjoying himself here. Jisko hum kehte hain na ki ayashi kar raha tha yahan par. He was largely only a nuisance. That's the way I look at it. But the leadership of Lashkar-e-Toiba has been affected, and we of course will now keep hunting for the other leaders in this area, and our aim is to keep clearing them out as soon as